Okay, before we start this week's video, I met up with a really nice couple, Jeff and Amanda Yaxley, my non-bred couriers. let me just explain that if you're new to the channel. There are a few things you can't get on this island. One of them is madras paste, the other one is naan breads, both of which I use a lot of during the winter. And my neighbour next door, Steve, who's been through the mill a few times, he loves the odd naan bread, Greek American, so he knows all about curries. He makes all sorts of things with them, though. He makes pizzas and all sorts. So yeah, anyway, they very kindly brought me out some naan breads, and we were talking about Black Sabbath. Now, this is something that I'd forgotten about because, I don't know, it's one of them things, isn't it, blowing your own trumpet or whatever. But let me tell you the story. When I was about 19, 20, maybe a bit older, I just started singing in pubs and clubs and stuff. And a friend of mine said to me, "Here's an advert. You might want to send the tape off and get an audition." I'd done a couple of auditions for bands, so I knew what it was like. So me and a friend, we hung a microphone off a lamp in the middle of the living room. I sang, he played. I sent some photographs, description of myself, all the things I'd asked for, to Seal Beach, California. Not thinking, Seal Beach, California. Anyway, this was at the beginning of the year. Towards the end of the year, just before Christmas, my friend said to me, "Did you get any response?" And I said, "No." And he said, "Well, never mind, mate. I'm not surprised." And he gave me the advert at the Birmingham Post and Mail, which is here, actually. I think I've got it in this card here. I don't know how well this is going to come out. It basically says that Tony Iommi and Bill Ward were looking for a singer. Well, I kicked off at that point and said, "Well, no wonder I didn't get, anything from that." Well, a few months later, the jiffy bag arrives with all my stuff in it. Somehow, I didn't get things like that back then, so I excitedly opened this jiffy bag. My tape fell out that I'd sent, the photographs and stuff, and there was a letter saying that basically I'd come third, but the other two were already in the States and they thought it was much easier to interview them first, and they picked one. But not to give up, they liked my voice, they liked my look, and I had a big future ahead of me, apparently. Anyway, the letter's long since disappeared, I can't find it, but I've just found this because Jeff Yaxley asked me about it. This is the Christmas card that I got from Bill Ward. I don't know how well that's coming out. And Tony Iommi, wishing me a Merry Christmas and all that sort of stuff. So yeah, was this close? I'm not complaining. I had a great time. I eventually went on to do other things, as you've probably seen if you watch the videos regular. I sang on stage several times with various bands. I've done some nice things. I even worked with a guy out of Selector, Noel Davis. I'm not sure whatever happened to him. If you're watching this, Noel, get in touch because I'd like to have a chat with you again. I haven't spoken to you for years. Anyway, yeah, I was in a band with him called Running Shoes. So that's that little bit of information. There you go, Jeff. You asked about it, and I stuck it on the site. It's not something I brag about, really. It's just one of those things, and it's nice to have. Let's get on with the video. Tom and Vicky, look, see?
Hi.
When we've got all the details, then we're going to do a series of videos, probably about 50 at this rate. And there's going to be a book being written as well.
Blonde lady.
A blonde lady.
It's really strong.
Coconut cream.
Coconut cream. It's going to be a whole new series of videos. A series of videos, no doubt. The Hobbit's got a blonde lady, so. What did you say? Oh. It's too funny. You need a camera on all the time when she's about. How can you be depressed when you've got a hobbit round with you? Strengthening your tush up, apparently.
Nice.
You like that, do you?
Yes.
A hobbit has a thing about maroon tops and white bottoms. It's Friday and welcome back to Rudgy, aka The Doctor. If you just joined us, hit the like, share and subscribe, sit back and enjoy the ride. And for those of you who visited the Ko-fi and PayPal this week, thank you ever so much for that. You're helping make these videos. Right, what have we got this week? Well, as you can see, the garden's looking lovely. However, there's the Hobbit relaxing in a swing seat. More about that later. As you can see, yeah, we're waiting for that to disappear. I've looked at the radar and it's going to be over there in another half an hour or so. We did debate on having something to eat at Villajaro and going out tonight. In fact, the Hobbit fancied some cheesy chips to watch the storm by, didn't you?
Yes.
It is like having a four-year-old Charlie, which is my younger daughter, around most of the time. Anyway, she's been sitting there watching the thunderstorm. Now, the reason I'm showing you this is that today is the 10th anniversary run for the air-cooled VW Club of Kefalonia, and I was invited to go along with a friend of mine. Of course, when you're on the bike, it's not so much fun riding around in the rain. And I suppose they're having much fun. They're supposed to be swimming today. That was their schedule. They were going to be driving from Sammy over to Scala, and they were going to be swimming this afternoon, and then they're setting off somewhere else for tea. Anyway, I'm going to see if we can go and find them now. The weather's supposed to be bucking up over that way. So more on this in a minute. Anyway, are we in a position where we might be able to think about making a move?
You want to go out in that?
Yeah.
Bye.
I mean, you're either in or you're out, aren't you, really?
Cheesy chips sitting there watching it. We might get drenched.
No, it's going that way, sausage.
It's got worse in the last 5 minutes.
Oh, has it really?
I've been watching it.
Yeah, well, I've looked at the radar and it's disappearing slowly.
Fine. Do you want a wager?
Yes, let's have another bet, shall we? As you can see, there's a couple of people being buried down there. I'm digging another one. I'm digging another one. Right, let's crack on. And the latest produce from the garden, some chili peppers here. Bell peppers. They've been on the plant for ages and just not getting any bigger. They seem to ripen. As you can see, they go red. That's one that was green. They don't seem to get any bigger. Tiny little things. So, if any of you know why that is, I'd be very interested in that. And maybe next year I can put that right, because I'll use them, but they're small, aren't they? So, there you go. Produce from the garden. I've got some tomatoes coming, and I've got another cucumber. So,
okay,
we can have a salad.
Well, it was discussed, and I gave in. the Hobbit wants cheesy chips. So cheesy chips it is, and then we'll probably go out. To be honest, the radar was showing that by now the weather should have moved over to the mainland, and it hasn't, so she probably had a good call. But she has had a bit of a rough time trying to buy a house here. What could go wrong did go wrong, so whatever she wants until she goes back to the UK, because she flies back in a week, she can have, as far as I'm concerned. So cheesy chips it is. On the balcony of Villajaro. Anyway, I best get on with them.
I want to be burning them.
Incidentally, I will be using olive oil to cook my chips. I've become sort of addicted to that now, and I think it's probably better for you, but you've got to be careful with olive oil that you don't burn the oil, because it becomes carcinogenic then. So you have to, takes a lot longer, let's put it that way. You have to have the heat a bit lower. I'm guessing it, but there is ways of doing that. But I haven't gone wrong yet. And you can tell when you burnt the oil, it's a different colour. I always use it a couple of times, and I pour it into some jam jars there, and I can see what colour it is then. So anyway, yeah, the other thing is, because I'm on a ring here, I have to keep turning the chips, stop them burning, because they settle on the bottom of the pan. Now I'm teaching my gran to suck eggs, but I'm sure a load of you know how to do chips. For goodness sake, everybody knows how to do chips, don't they? I usually do them in a frying pan, but when there's two of you, you need...
What other thing I'm keen on doing? Before the
oil gets up to a raging temperature, where it will turn the chips crisp, I put them in, because that way I found it cooks the inside of the chip. Well, I'm teaching my gran to suck eggs again, I'm sure. So what I'm going to do now, just before they go brown, is pull them out, rest them for a minute, get the oil hot, bang them back in.
Crispy, fluffy chips.
They're almost cooked, but I'm going to leave them to rest. Of course, most things keep cooking when you take them out of the heat. Potatoes being no exception. And of course, they're over hot oil. I have, as you've noticed, took the oil off the heat for a minute. I don't want to burn the oil either. So, right, there we go. Chips are back in. Usually takes about 25 minutes, something like that. Maybe a bit longer with the olive oil. As I said, you've got to be careful with the temperature. You don't want to burn the oil. I have to say, the cheese that Jackie picked, the Hobbit, that is, doesn't melt very easily. Right, we're going to see what she makes of that. How's that, Hobbit?
Very good. Very nice. Cheesy chips. Rudd style.
Hobbit just said they're the best chips I've ever done. And I said, why?
Well, they're soft inside. They're not hard.
See, I told you, double fry your chips.
So how did you double fry them? What do you mean?
Well, you'd have to watch the video, won't you, sausage?
Ah, what did you do? Are these oven chips?
Oven chips?
Do you mean they double? So you fried them and took them out and then fried them again?
Yes. Because it's olive oil and you can't get the temperature too high because you burn the oil. So you end up with a soggy chip. Nobody wants a soggy chip, especially the Hobbit. She likes a good portion and she likes it nice and crunchy.
You can't keep saying that.
I just did. Right, so me and the Hobbit, we rode out to Scala. It's the 10th anniversary of the air-cooled Kefalonian Club. As you know, I follow them around quite a lot, as I've got a few friends in there. Now, I deciphered from the pictures this morning where they were parked. Erasmus had posted a few bits and pieces about it, and I had the itinerary. So then it rained, as you've just seen. Me and the Hobbit decided to have cheesy chips and hang out for a bit. They're not due to be in Sammy until another hour or two yet. So we headed for the car park and, Anyway, luckily for me, I found this gentleman here with this lovely van. And what's your name, sir?
Gandhi.
Yeah. So you've come from?
Albania.
It's come from Albania, guys. I mean,
first time with this bus.
Yeah.
5 years trying to find the way to come to take part of the 7th. And finally, I didn't wait to finish the bus. I put the things in because it will never work to make a thing perfect.
No.
I put the kids inside and here we are.
Yeah. That's the best way.
Yeah, that's the best way.
Yeah.
I regret wasting so much time trying to make things work perfect, but it will never be perfect with those cars.
Yeah.
It's the time you spend with them.
Yeah. You have to enjoy it.
Yes.
Time is short.
My kids are enjoying, my wife is enjoying, so what I want
more. Yeah.
It's not beautiful, it's not finished, it's only with the primer, it's working.
It's good enough.
Yeah, it's good enough. So this time is good enough. In the future, I'm going to get better.
But you've done an adventure in it.
Yes.
So now you've got close.
Yes. Yeah. And I like it. My kids love it.
So this is the family.
Yeah, this is family. Yeah. Anthony, Nicole.
Yeah.
So we go now to the camping and I hope we see you there.
Yeah, we'll see you.
With many, many buses.
We're going to head off to Sammy and probably catch up with you there.
You are welcome.
Yeah. We'll have a quick look around your bus.
Yeah,
looks all right to me.
Well, it's only epoxy primer, it's not restored.
Yeah, that's the fashion now.
Yeah. And a lot of investment in them.
Yeah. So there you go, the only other one is, this one looks like it's from Poland over here. And there's another one parked up here. Let's see what the plate is on this one. Oh, that's a Greek one, so that could be one of our lot. So, I mean, it's not a disaster. We'll find them. The island's not massive. We're only 300 square mile. So, and as you know, I know every inch of it, so we'll find them. I notice there's a German bus here. There you go. So, I'm going to wait for the Hobbit to come back with the water. and we'll be back in a second. Right, so we're now in Sami, having driven across the mountain. I left the Albanian guy. He was a bit confused, so I hope you made it, mate. I hope you followed the signage. So now we're on the campsite, the Sami way. And I don't know whether you can spot that, but it's a British plate. And then there's another one there. These guys have driven over from the UK to be here. So we've seen Albanian. There's some Swiss guys up there. They're from all over the place. So there's, what's your name?
Simon.
Simon, there
Simon
you go.
And Carol.
Simon and Carol.
Hi.
Yeah.
So I think they're extremely brave. but they've had a good adventure, I can tell you that for nothing.
Well, this is our third year in a row.
Oh, we've done it three years in a row.
But only with the Beetle and the van last year.
Yeah.
First time we just came in the van.
Ah, right.
And you couldn't meet a better bunch of people.
They're no, they're so great, lovely. Aren't they? Oh, yeah.
Just amazing.
They're all raving mad.
Well, there's a few.
Yeah. The problem I've got is I live here and I bump into two of them quite a lot, well, three of them quite a lot. So, yeah.
Chris.
Yeah, and Chris. Chris Harris and Erasmus, yeah.
Erasmus,
yeah. Yeah, he is nuts.
He posts every 5 minutes.
He does, yeah.
He's great.
Yeah, yeah. So, okay. Yeah, they've got a campsite set up here. I'll have a little walk around and you can have a look and show you what's going on. For those of you who aren't interested in beetles, well, this is going to be quite a boring video for you. So that's the British crew. I'm not quite sure, I'm not very good on my platage. I think that's Swiss, that one there. Everywhere you look, they completely took the campsite over. Some Greek plates there, so they're locals. I've seen that bus before, to be fair. Serbian plates there. Another one there. Oh, look at that. Now, see, I've just got rid of a T4. German plated. And down there, look. So really, everywhere you look on this campsite is a Volkswagen. Completely took the place over. I think it's fantastic. So I'm going to go back and see if I can find a few people that I know, because there's a lot of local people there. I would imagine that the ones that live here aren't going to be camping, are they? Split screen now. Look at that. Just have a quick wander down there, because there's quite a few down this way. I think Jack is trying to buy the convertible. For those of you who haven't really had much to do with this crew, they're all completely raving mad and they all know how to have a good time. I've hung about with them now for the past 3 years or so. I only met them really because I was videoing for the channel. If you flick through, you'll see a few videos. One or two of them were like, you know, just, oh, look, some beetles, don't know what that's about. And then the last one, I think, was when they were at Fenari Lighthouse, beach buggy down there. I spotted something that I really do like. Look at this. Look at that. Now that's something else, isn't it? Now, I think I was probably 14 when I had my first Beetle, and it had wheels pretty similar to that all around. So I get quite nostalgic when I see a beetle running wide steelies. There's just so much to look at if you're into beetles. Look at that. Ideal for this country. Now we're on another road. There's a Swiss rat beetle there, look. Beetles hiding in the foliage. Beetles with feathers on. What a cool place. In fact, I'm going to cut through here. There's a lot of beetles through here. I do like my beetles, I have to admit. Who knows, maybe I won't bother with a Jeep. Maybe I'll get a beetle. Look at these, look. Cute, isn't it? I do like a split screen as well. There's two here, look. Now, I'm sorry about the quality of the filming on this one, but I'm constantly scanning, going, oh, look at that. It's like you're trying to concentrate on something, you go, squirrel. Yeah. I'm loving this. I hope you are too. Just got to find my way back to the bike now. And then, of course, got to find our way out. There's the bike. Hello, Hobbit.
I love their convertible. The bug one.
Oh, right.
Really nice.
You like that, do you?
Yes. Yeah. It's like the one I sent you with the maroon top. Like the speedboat that was white with the maroon top.
Hmm. The Hobbit has a thing about maroon tops and white bottoms.
Do you have to?
Well, I didn't mention portion. She's off. She's going to go and buy one. So we're just driving out of the campsite, and for those of you who are probably interested in doing this again, if you go to the VW Air Cooled Club of Kefalonia, if they're doing this again next year, it'll be posted on there. I will probably make a bit of a noise about it before it happens anyway. So that's the campsite in Sami, and the Hobbit went, oh, can we take a picture? Look at her. I think she might have been converted to air-cooled beetles, but that is quite a nice specimen, to be fair. I'm not quite sure where it's from. It's a Greek plated one. It's on classic plates. Now the problem with that is, you can correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty certain that's a classic plate, and if it is, you can only drive it on a bank holiday or a Sunday. I think they were on about changing that, but look at it, absolutely mint. There is a guy on the island restoring these, I think, and it looks like one of his. It's certainly done a really good job of that. I like that. I could drive around quite happily in that. Oh, actually, no, it's got normal plates on the front. I'm going to correct myself there then. Maybe they lost the back number plate or something. I don't know. Anyway, leave in the comments. I'm sure Chris is watching this. Leave in the comments about the number plate. I'm a bit confused now. I thought I was up to speed with those, but obviously not. Anyway, we're now going to go and get something to drink, and we're going to meet up with them, aren't we?
Yeah.
At the taverna, where there's going to be music and food. Hobbit seems quiet.
We're going to ride back to the dock.
Yes.
In the rain.
Yes, in the rain, by the looks of it. Which is where we started this video. See, I'm an old hand at this. The Hobbit, well, she's yet to experience it.
I might moan all the way back.
Hello, Kanika.
Hey, look
right,
at this.
So here we are in the port of Sami. Just see my mate there in the campsite. Had my picture took with him. We're going to meet up with him now and then probably go and get something to eat and watch the bands and what have you. But this is where they're all meeting, just here. So we'll have some more Beatles and things that you haven't seen yet. There's Harris, the president of the club.
It's a new one.
And again, plates from all around the world. Right, I'm going to go and get a beer and then we'll follow them out to wherever we're going. So I'm not quite sure where the restaurant is. Just going to see if the Hobbit's got me a beer yet. So I've had a beer stop and pretty much everybody's turned up, I think. So the Hobbit's over there paying for the beer. I thought I'd just take her a quick tour of the cars that are on show here. and then we're off for something to eat, I think. I've just seen the ration that goes back, so. So, let's do a bit of a zigzag. Look at that. Now that is the perfect vehicle for her. Look at that. And this is something you don't see very much these days, especially as a rat rod, which is what I think you'd call it. Carmen gear. Look at that. What a fantastic car. So let's go down here and have a look. Look at that, that's absolutely mint. If I'm not getting all the vehicle in, it's because there isn't a lot of room here. And as I said earlier, there are vehicles from all over Europe. Nice to see a few British vehicles here. It's one of our own. It's a local car. I would like to walk down every corridor to film it, but it's going to take me forever. And the filming probably won't be very good. So I'm just going to pick on a few cars that I like. And they are still coming. And we are going to follow them on Nikki. How cool is that? I think this is my favourite. I love that. Look at that. Out of all the wonderful things here, the beach buggy and that are my favourite. I mean, must be something wrong with me. There you go. I'm going to get back on the Black Pearl and get ready for him to leave, because I'm not exactly certain where we're going. But we're going. I mean, me and the Hobbit are going to ride back in what looks like dreadful weather. Thunder, lightning, rain. And trust me, when you get up over the mountain, and that's the way we're going to have to go, it will be raining. There are two ways out of here, actually. I was thinking of going that way, over to here for Mia, which is the quickest route, and into Augustale that way. But I think we'll probably go back through the back of Sammy and out that way, because there's less cloud there, so hopefully it'll be all right. So there we are, they're all about to go out, so we're going to try and film them now. And Hobbit was saying that we might not get a table.
Well, boom. I think we will. We're going to have a go.
We'll follow them.
Look at
this. So what I intend to do now, if my battery holds up, is I'm going to film them all going out, and I'm going to try and get you some footage from the bike, and we're going to tag on behind them. Because Nick is welcome anywhere. So let's clip you on. He must have had special permission to do this.
You see all the drones up in the air?
Yeah. That was the Port Authority, by the way. And again. There's some of the local cars going out, that beach buggy.
What is it?
What's that? The Carmen Gear.
Yeah. A what?
Carmen Gear. I like that, look at that.
Yeah,
that is absolutely
nice.
Mint. But then I like that as well. And I like that.
Yeah, that's what I love. Love it. That's
what I would buy. I'm in the wrong sales office. I hope this footage is coming out. So the problem we've got, viewers, is I can't
see. That's quite nice too.
Yeah. I like the wheels on the back of that.
Yeah.
The problem we've got, viewers, is I can't see what you're seeing because you're strapped to my chest currently, so I can't see the screen. So we might not get the footage we require here, but I'm doing my best. And my gran said, if you do your best, nobody can criticise you. And it's just started raining. So the Hobbit's going to get her first ride in the rain on Nikki.
I can hold the camera for you.
That's right, she's back down there now. We're nearly done anyway, they're nearly all out, aren't they? There is some quality vehicles here. There's probably better quality vehicles here than you would see in the UK. We'll just wait for the last one and then we'll tag on behind, and hopefully the one on the back is going where we're going. Otherwise, I'm a bit lost. Hobbit likes this one here, the Carmen Gear, which I think is a good shout, to be fair. You don't see many. We'll follow the mystery machine, which takes me back to my childhood, really, the mystery machine. I remember lying on my mum's floor on the rug in front of the gas fire watching that. Scooby Snacks. Anyway, enough of that. I'm going to turn you off for a minute now, save me battery. There's the Hobbit's favourite car. I think it might be mine as well. Look at that.
Yeah, gorgeous, low light.
Yeah, they're only original ones, aren't they? Well, yeah, not that it's that original, he slammed it, but yeah. I mean...
Right, cool, so in here, in the barn, yeah. Looks right. Looks like we've got most of the local cars in there.
I apologise for the camera shake, but not a lot we can do about that. Let's have another look at this Carmen Gear, because the Hobbit seems to like it. I must admit, I think it's pretty cool.
There, I'll clean the camera lens because it got a bit wet on the
the way out of Sammy.
Half does, is it?
Anyway, let's have another look at the car park, because it's just an unbelievable amount of vehicles that are here now. Absolutely unbelievable. Look at that, the row after row after row of Beetles. Now, I did have some statistics on the Beetles last time I did one of these, about how many were made, when they finished making the last one, but I've forgotten now. So, you can help me out in the comments if you want. As you can see up there, still lightning going on. We've got to ride through that, me and the Hobbit, but she doesn't seem too bothered, bless her. Harris has got all the cars lined up here. He works hard, bless him, to get all this sorted out. He's got the two bugs down here. And apart from that one, it's all vans. Now, these things here, I knew a lot about them once upon a time, but I'm having a bad day and I can't remember. Leave in the comments. But that's how old I am. I've worked on pretty much everything in here. Well, yeah, I've worked on everything in here. Not literally everything in here, but, you know, the type of vehicle. And there is the Volkswagen's Hark Back from the future. Yeah, well, I haven't got a lot of love for those, really, but there you go. Oh, look, there's a little Fiat 500 there. The Hobbit's after one of those. There she is, look, waiting for her dinner. She could eat a horse, apparently. Could you eat a horse?
I could eat a horse.
But not Kylie, because that's a different lifestyle.
You're going to get run over? Mm. Perhaps I shouldn't tell you.
Well. Yeah. Right, well, as you can see, it's a busy night in this taverna. Yeah, let's have a look and see what we can do, because you're hungry, aren't you? Still got lightning going on over the backdrop there. Yes. We'll get moist, won't we?
Can we have a hot bath when we get back?
Yes. Now, those of you who know anything about editing will know that at this point I've sat there for about 10 minutes trying to find the lightning shot, going, I'm sure there was one. Well, there it is. Right, let's go and get something to eat. Okay, so that's this week's video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't already, hit the like, share and subscribe. Sit back and enjoy the ride. And as I said earlier, if you visited the Ko-fi and PayPal page this week, thank you ever so much for that. Your name will be coming up shortly. And by the way, somebody's asked me about that. I edit these films usually on a Wednesday and then post them onto the YouTube ready to go early hours of Friday morning. So if you go to the PayPal and Ko-fi page before Wednesday, then your name will appear, but obviously it'll be the following week if you did it on a Wednesday afternoon. Anyway, now we've explained that, we're in the beautiful port of Sammy, and I'll see you guys next week. Don't be late. What are you doing, sausage? Have you got a bit distracted? Were you looking for something?
I was looking for something. I thought this was nail varnish remover and it's not.
Mm.
Now I've made a mess.
Yeah.
And then...
Yeah.
I haven't got any drawers and everything's getting crumpled. Do you really have to?
We're going to have to sort you out a bigger wardrobe, aren't we? So what I think we should do is get rid of the beds and then you'll have a bigger open plan wardrobe. This is the problem with the Hobbits, you see. you have to make sure they've got plenty of room to put stuff, otherwise it doesn't really work. What do you want for breakfast?
Sausages.
Sausage. Sausage for a sausage. You like a good portion of sausage, don't you?
Are you off again?
Hello, Lucanica. So, yeah, as you can see, I've done the prep work because it wants Lucanica Inglesica. And if you want to know where to get them, if you're on the island and you want English sausage and English bacon, Petro Supermarket in Lourdes, well actually La Hata, he has them, and the meat market. Don't think I should be telling you really, because they do run out, okay? A bit like a Richmond sausage, really. And then what's happening?
Then we're going out for afternoon tea.
Oh, are you taking a handbag on the bike?
I'm taking a handbag on the bike.
Instead of the rucksack.
I would wear a dress, but I don't think I can manage that.
Well, you have to ride side saddle.
For pear cheesecake up at the castle.
Mm.
Very nice.
Yeah.
We're going to get fat today.
Going to get another portion off Spiro.
It better give me a big portion, actually.
Yeah, well, yeah. Last time it was just right, wasn't it, the portion you had?
It was, but I wouldn't mind if it was too big this time.
Well, I'm afraid I'm going to. I mean, if nobody else, it amuses Ian Redmond and Sarah, doesn't it?
Getting a big portion up the castle.
Yeah.
I don't mind when it's pudding.
No.
But when it's your main, it's got to be the right size.
Yeah, just right, yeah.
Pudding can be on the large size.
Especially when
size.
It's balls. Meatballs. Salted meatballs.
Neptune's balls.
Yeah, Neptune's balls.
It is actually on the menu, Neptune's balls.